Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look at a pack from Motion VFX. I have talked about their products earlier. There are two free products for DaVinci Resolve 17. So if you didn't see those videos, take a look down in the description below. So in this video, we're going to have a look at the M Channel Clean, which is meant specific for content creators to spice up their edit with transitions and overlays and stuff like that. In this video, we're going to have a look at what is inside the pack, how does it work, is it useful for you as a content creator? So with that out of the way, let's get right to this video. Oh, and by the way, if you are new to this channel and want to learn DaVinci Resolve filmmaking tips and tricks and want to have a look at some pretty cool gear, I would recommend you to subscribe. Alrighty, with that out of the way, let's get right to the video. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and let's have a look at the M Channel Clean pack from Motion VFX, and let's just get right to it. So let's go up in the effects, and under effects, if we scroll down, we are going to have our M Channel Clean right here. This consists of different elements. Let's just start out here with the M Channel Clean add-on. We can drag this and add it into our clip from New York. And this is what we have. This graphic here. Of course, we can select the clip, go up to the inspector, and go into effects. And here we can change the different things. For instance, we could change the sliders, so it will be something else. We can change the background fade in, so it will change color, and also we can change the zoom amount a bit. So we could do some kind of an animation of this if we wanted to. Pretty easy, just by going to the beginning of the clip here. Let's see, we're going to have it like that. We'll go at the beginning of the clip, and we're going to put in a keyframe here at the zoom amount, and we'll go to the end, and we're just going to zoom something like that. So now we have this effect done pretty fast and pretty easy. Of course, it just needs to render so we can see it in real time. Like that. There we go. So that is one way of working with these. I'll just show you all of the clean add-on ones right now. There is 10 of them. So this is what you have in the pack. Next up, we are going to have some clean backgrounds like this. For instance, we have a clean background here. We can drag that onto a clip. And we're going to have this clean background effect. And again, we can, of course, select the clip, go up to the inspector and under effects. And here we have the different controls we can change. Again, we can change the frame position, whatever we want. We can change the height and the width, if we want to do something very specific, or we can invert the stuff so it'll be something like this instead. We can change the contrast and the brightness of the thing, and also the saturation, something like that. We can make unique looks pretty fast like that. So we can kind of make unique graphics just like that pretty fast. And in this pack, there is 7 different clean backgrounds you can use, and I'll show you all of them right here. Thank you. So in the pack we also have some clean intros, and a clean intro is something you can put on a clip. And let's have a look here. We are going to have some kind of a intro. It takes a little time to run because it needs to do the rendering, like it is with all of the different stuff in the pack. Of course, we can select the clip and we can go into the inspector under effects and change, in this case, it's a logo intro. So we can change the logo, we can change the control or the titles. Also, if there is a subtitle, we can change that. And of course, we can use some frame controls and simply just make things way more cool. So I'll show you all of the different clean intros, and there is 6 of them in the pack, so here they are. In the pack, we also have some different overlays, like a color overlay, like here. We also have a flip overlay, an invert overlay, and of course, we have a letterbox overlay, so you can make that cinematic look right on your footage by just adding this. Also, we have a progress overlay, something which could be kind of cool. And a texture overlay. If we go over to our titles and we're going to go to the M channel clean, we have actually a selection of lower thirds, which are always nice to have in your toolbox. Again, these can be added on top of our video clips and they can be changed inside the inspector. And again, we can have different controls and stuff like that. And again, a nice thing to have in your toolbox. So here is a look of all of the different lower thirds in the pack. So in the pack, we also have some social media bars like this one. This is a clean social media bar. This is YouTube. But the cool thing about this pack is we can actually go in and change stuff around again in the inspector. And if we go in and use the logo controls here, we can change this to any social media or at least the most relevant ones. For instance, let's say Facebook, we could change it to that. And then we could change the text here to something else. And also we could change around element controls. In this case, this is being the colors of the elements right here. We can change that around. So in the pack, there is 10 different social media graphics, and we'll have a look at those right here. Also included in the pack are 7 different titles, and they will work like any title. You can put them on top of your video clip. It'll just cache, and then you'll have the title showing up just like you see right here. And of course, if we select the title itself, we can go in and control everything the way we want it and make it look exactly like we want, so it fits to our social media videos or whatever kind of video you are making. So here is a look at all of the different titles, 7 of them to be precise. So that was a look at the M-Channel Clean Pack from Motion VFX. I think it's a lovely pack, great if you are doing social media videos, small documentaries and stuff like that. Also, if you are interested, take a look down in the description below. There will be an affiliation link. It will not cost you anything else to use the link, but it will help out the channel. So if you want some of the VFX packs, please use the link. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.